Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to the workshop. It's been a while since I've thrown anything on the bench from Revell USA. We got kits in. We saw them in the last new kits video. If you haven't checked out that new kits video, it's from 1 week ago today. Look at it. Check it out. You will think it's absolutely awesome. So now we are going to be building up the 1977 Chevy Street pickup truck. Includes newly tooled wheels. So that'll be pretty cool to check those out in the box. Looks like they're going to be that revolver style, a five-shot revolver. Must be a small 38 special. We're going to be building this up. As you know, in this one, if you don't already know, there is no way to build this up as a stock square body. This will be a lowered truck with custom accessories only in the box. Of course, you can take this and kit bash it, do whatever you want with it on your own, but as it comes in the box, the way I review things, it cannot be built as a completely stock ride height or wheel package or exhaust or anything of the 77 Chevys. 77 would be, of course, a cool year for me. That's the year I came into production, and I haven't been re-released yet, but maybe someday that will happen. First up in the white styrene, I am glad to see this thing has things like mirror mounting holes. You know, even if they're indentations on the other side and we can drill them out. So we've got the factory badging on here, and we'll see if we've got some decals for that. The firewall is pretty flat on this one. It is an older style mold, but we've got our jack, our blower motor, we've got our booster there, we've got our reservoir, we've got a Delco battery under the hood and some lines, so it's not actually bad. The radiator does have texture to it, so it is pretty basic under the hood. Nice lines though, they get the square body right with that long flat hood. This one's got a pre-cut sunroof. Again, you can't do it without the sunroof. It does have the drip rail, so you can either just paint over that as a custom truck, or it would look really nice accented on that vehicle, depending on the body color that you decide to go with. We got our windshield frame, and the windshield wipers are molded in on this one. The back is open, so I assume we're going to have to attach the back on it. On this parts tree here, we've got that big slab hood with the three vents across there. Underneath, it is flat. There is no insulation or webbing under there. We've got our lower front body pan. We've got our sport mirrors, so don't cut those pins off. And we've got some vents here. We've got what looks like the radiator shroud, exhaust pipes. I thought these would be velocity stacks at first, but they are not. They are part of the exhaust outlets right here. We've got the top of our engine intake system and distributor all in one. We've got part of our intake here, which probably glues on the side. Some small shrouding for the engine. Looks like a air box right there. Only 83 parts in this kit total. Shouldn't be a very long build process. We've got our wood bed here. The wood grain looks wonderful in there. It is all textured, and I love that the chrome, the metal rails, the chrome or painted, however you want to do your custom truck, are raised from the surface, which makes it a lot easier to paint those as well if you want to do them later. Got our tailgate in there, got our fenders, got the back of our cab with window molding, got our interior, bench seat. Door panels are pretty much non-existent on this. Not seeing really any detail unless we have to glue it in later. Nice seat in there. Got our floor shifter and our three pedals on the carpeted floor. On the next parts tree, we've got our manifolds. These are your only exhaust options. Custom steering wheel. Here's our carbureted intake on there with distributor, 350 block transmission, starter, fuel pump, all molded in, oil filter. It's actually detailed for having just two pieces on it. Got our radiator here, so we do have more detail for the radiator. Fuel tank. We've got what looks like more exhaust lines here for options. Front steering. Two-wheel drive pickup, clearly. Drive shaft, belt and pulley system. And I think that's the tailgate or the front of the box. That's got to be the tailgate. The other one was the front of the box. On that parts tree. Moving over to the final tree. We've got that square body dashboard. You can wood grain this. It looks really cool. You can vinyl it. The bottom would be painted. So you can custom paint that or just do it all in one paint color, whatever you choose. We've got a separate frame with floor pan, transmission hump on it. Got our differential. Got our springs with shocks built in. Glue right to that frame. That is our white styrene. We'll move over. We'll look at something pretty cool on this truck here is a tinted windshield and sunroof. Now, in my area, if you tried to get 4 feet out of your driveway with a tinted windshield, you would be done for. We got side lights, back glass as one piece. You can always, of course, cut this and cut this, use the side lights, and this would be easy to duplicate and clear acetate if you decided to go that way, and then our sunroof. We'll see how those glue in. We'll see the kind of glues I like to use for that stuff. We've got a set of big and little tires, shallow tread patterns, so be careful when you're sanding. I see no name or brand call out. They are solid vinyl rubber, and they come right off the tree. You can see the branch they cut them off of. They just hang like that down in Illinois. And the guy from Revell USA, they go out and snip them off and put them in every model kit that they decide to use them in. We've got a clear, all right, chrome parts tree. We got our side steps for the truck. Custom valve covers are a must. We've got a custom differential gear carrier. We've got side step or tail lights for the truck in chrome. You could glue those on and paint them body color, which would be very, very common to do on a custom truck. We got those sweet revolver style wheels. This truck screams that it was customized in the 90s. Got our wheel backs here in chrome. Got our grill molded open with headlights molded in. You can fill that with Mod Podge. What is Mod Podge, Chris? It's just this craft brush on adhesive glue. It's really like a diluted white glue. But when it dries crystal clear and does resemble glass. So we can try that on those headlights since they're sunk in and see if we can get those to look a little bit more like they have a lens on them. And that is it for the chrome tree. We've got a nice decal sheet. Check it out. We got three. This is all 90s. And I had actually talked to my guy down there about how in the 90s everything was teal, blue, with a pink squiggly. And they did that right. You could also use this sheet on that sweet teal-colored, turquoise-colored dually or the Silverado, the regular one that had been released by AMT. You can save these decal sheets for stuff like that. That would be awesome on there. We got the Scottsdale emblems for the fenders, so they are on here. That'll make very easy paintwork. We've got custom gauges or stock gauges for the dashboard. We've got our marker lights on there. We've got more 350 emblems. We've got some bullet hole style emblems, the multi-hole there. We've got all these cool license plates and the different color. We got stock colors for the Chevy emblems and all the customs. All these just scream 1990s graphics. The hash marks and everything. Even has Tuned-Port Injection decals, TPI 350. Pretty cool. A lot of stuff on that decal sheet. A lot of right-sized emblems. So I'm going to start gluing my little guy together. I love square bodies. We got a beautiful box art buildup on the side. They went with a purple tone, black and purple, with a purple tinted glass, purple engine. I don't think I'm going to go exactly that route, but I sure like the looks of that custom truck. So I'm going to get to gluing mine together right now. Thank you. Working on a model with only about 83 pieces usually isn't that difficult, and this one wasn't too hard. The chassis and suspension can be fiddly because there aren't really positive location marks for the axles on those springs. In the rear, it kind of sits right in the little cradle there, and it's not too bad at all. In the front, it's just flat block to flat block because you want it to rise up and you want it to be dropped real low in the nose. You can see on the box art, that front wheel, that tire's up under the fender, same as it is on the built-up models. The rear, it sits higher. It's got some rake to it. The front end is dropped way down in the weeds, trying to find every incline it can. So we've got that assembled on there. I'm going to do that all up together as one unit. I prefer strength over individuality on those parts when I do them because of the way that I build. And then after that, everything else is pretty much cream cheese. What I did for the exhaust was I just left it pinned together the way it was on the tree because I like that little joiner in there. I think that's something that would be in real life as well to keep each one of these individual tips from rattling against each other. I think they would have put some sort of cap on there or whatever. So I left it that way, trimmed it off the back end, and that allowed me to line everything flat on the table and run glue across and get both of my exhaust systems so that when they're under the truck, will come out and be evenly spaced and look nice. That was really, you know, pretty simple to do and a decision I made to do it that way, and I'm glad I did. There isn't a ton of other stuff to assemble. We've got the belt and pulley system. We've got the TPI intake, which is, you know, small parts, but they do line up and they do have indents on there for you. The box goes together without much trouble at all. Just make sure you line up your fenders with these pegs on the bottom. And then you've got those all set. Make sure the step goes towards the front so you can put your chrome steps on and stuff when you're done. We got our taillights on the back. I did sand the chrome off and use model glue to hold those on along with the tailgate latches on the back because I want to paint that with the body. And then I'll just chrome the centers and then tint them with either Tamiya clears or Sharpie markers. So we've got the bed all assembled. The bed is ready to go. And then I'm going to wood grain my bed on my custom truck. You can paint it. You can do whatever you want. You know, that's completely up to you. On the cab, we got the back end. It is very, very thin. And the mounting points, the little tabs all the way around are there. So just get them wet with glue and then carefully adjust it in place so that it's flush all the way along the back. We still should be able to get the full interior in without a fight and all that stuff. We'll have to squeeze it in there, but we'll get it in. It'll fit, the body will flex, and let me push it in from the front and then slide it in and get it back up in there. Then I did attach the front bumper. I wanted body color, and it makes no difference to mounting it on the chassis, so that's why I attached it. Folks, that's pretty much it. You know, I had the little excerpt there. Do you ever forget what you're doing? When I was gluing these wheels in, I'm like, am I doing it the right direction? And I looked at the manual, and then I kind of had a brain fart. We all do that all the time. So I left it in. I don't mind about stuff like that. All this chrome here, I think I'm going to flat coat with a matte clear and make it all look brushed instead of chromey chrome. I think that's how I want it on the entire truck. I don't want anything being super shiny chrome on this rig at all. I want it to be metallic, but not chrome. So that's it. We've got our 350 assembled. That is just two halves that we saw with the intake dropped over the top. The TPI will then drop on. Once we get our valve covers on, I'll glue that on there. I'll paint it separately so I can attach it and do some other detail painting. That's it, folks. So not much to go on there. I have pre-washed all the large pieces, the hood, the tailgate. The reason I'm leaving the tailgate off is so I can brush in the bed and get that all painted up. Leaving all that stuff separate so that I can get it all painted easily. And I washed everything with Simple Green. Scrubbed it off, and then let it dry, and we are set for the paint session, which you will see right now. Time to examine what I've got going on with the Chevy, the 77 Chevy by Revell USA. I've got the interior done and glued together. We've got the CB radio in there. The CB is built into the dash, molded in, so you just have to attach the microphone. After detail painting, I use the stock style decals, the super small decals, these little microscopic 1 millimeter decals I did not use because I was using black, so I just did the black wash in there. Can't see it really anyways, and then detailed the radio, the temperature control, got our floor shifter in place, painted the boot, and left the interior the tan, and did some billet aluminum accents. They used to make them, you could stick to the dash, you could stick to the gauges and everything, and it looks nice, and they get the dash looking perfect. I got the side steps for the bed all set up. They are two-piece side steps. So we'll attach those when we do the final assemblies. Once we get the cab on and everything, we'll get those side steps attached. And I left the back a black, like it was that vinyl rubber to keep you from denting the back of it. Got the exhausts all chromed up with that Revell chrome, and that is outstanding. Got them black washed on the inside. We'll glue those up underneath here when we're all done, underneath the chassis itself. I did have an issue. They want you to glue the gas tank more far forward where those little T-grooves are, but it's not going to fit with that differential housing off the back like that. It's just not going to fit at all. So I grooved it a little more and put it on that last frame rail. Not perfectly accurate, but something a customizer would end up having to do if they went and did all that other stuff and couldn't locate the fuel tank where they normally would. So we've got our exhausts here. They will line up with the headers and glue right to the frame rail when we're all done, when we have the body on. Then I will attach those on the side, and that's what they will look like. Got the bed all done up, the tailgate's pressed in. I did the bed rails with the Sharpie. Like I said, I didn't want any chrome on here. I did everything with the Sharpie to simulate billet aluminum. A lot of the cabs on these trucks will have black rubber seals. I wanted to dress it up a little bit since it is, you know, a custom street truck. I did billet aluminum trim all the way around. Same with the taillights, did it in Sharpie. Did the drip rails, did the side lights, did the windshield and the back glass trim all in a Sharpie so that it would look like it was all billet aluminum. We've got the grill here. I did accent inside those grooves with black wash just to darken it down a little bit. Got our Mod Podge in for the lights, which does resemble glass enough. Not as good, but it doesn't look as bad as bare chrome. And then use the Tamiya clear yellow for that Chevy emblem over the chrome so that it does shine like the real ones do. I have to attach the mirrors and part of the intake system for the TPI once it's all together. Did the black wash on the hood. That 350 drops into the engine bay very easily. It actually attaches with a point back here, and the motor mounts line up perfectly with our drive shaft and everything. So it is looking good. We got our wheel and tire package on. I just sanded those by hand instead of using my socket set that I usually do. So that's it. I'm going to get the final assembly done on the truck. Some things we should talk about as far as fit and finish. We talked about the gas tank. The wheels fit onto the axles very loosely, so they will have to be glued. They will not fit super tight, or at least they didn't on my model. And the glass, the only glass that fits well in this entire vehicle is the sunroof. The windshield and the back glass are an absolute pain. I had to cut them and a quarter inch out, and then I also had to notch those bands going backwards because they will interfere with the fit of the sunroof. So I had to detach them and then hold them in place and glue them in place. And, you know, they still fit a little wonky. You can see the side light when the windshield is perfect. The side glass is a little off, and the back glass leans in a little bit on the top. So not a perfect fit with that glass, given that it's an older design. I'm surprised I didn't have more troubles than that. So that's how that goes in. Also, I painted that radiator up for nothing because it will not fit. The fan and everything, once the engine's in the correct position, will hit. And I had this glued in here because I thought it would look really nice, and it doesn't work out. So I just went in and painted the radiator black. We'll go with a stock black radiator on this one then at this point. And I painted everything under hood and did the inner fenders in the blue because it is a custom truck. So we got our battery, jack, accented a little bit with some metallic paint, but that's it. So I'm gonna get the final assemblies done, slide the interior up, drop the cab on, put the grill in, put the chrome TPI custom intake on the engine once everything's in place, and then attach the air cleaner, attach the mirrors. I did the mirrors in a sport black gloss, painted the inside. We'll get all that done, and I will return for the final. There you have it, the 1977 Chevy Street pickup by Revell USA. We got those big side pipes on and that gorgeous Revell chrome spray paint. I use that very sparingly because of the cost. We got the nice grill in there, the bumper replacement on the front end, those newly tooled wheels on there. The truck has no rear bumper, so I didn't leave it off. There is no rear bumper in the kit. We got those custom taillights on the back. Position those exactly as you want. We got the beautiful sport mirrors, and I left them in black. We got the Scottsdale emblems on it. We got the bow tie options. We got all kinds of graphics. On this one, I did the teal and blue, and they are very, very subtle. So you can just see them on there with that pink squiggly. In person, they stand out more, but that's how I like it. And then I did a wood grain box instead of painting over it, which painting over it would be very common on a custom truck. With those stripes and these wheels, it kind of dates it to the late 80s, mid 90s era. You know, I'd say from about 88 to, you know, 95, 96 in the Midwest, probably more like 87 to now, because a lot of people forget what year it is around the Midwest here where I live. We still have guys wearing mullets and girls with crispy bangs, so yeah. Anyways, I enjoyed the pickup. The final fitment is pretty good. The box goes on the chassis very easily, but the fuel tank really doesn't fit well with that quick change rear end cover. And the cab, the interior slides into the cab. Just go from the front end, and the bottom of the doors will spread open, and then it will go up at an angle and slide into the cab. And then the cab goes down on the chassis pretty easily. It's not much of a fight. You will have to stretch the back corners a little bit to get it over that interior pan that we see on there. But once you get it on there, then you know it's in solidly, and you really don't have to glue anything. The front of the frame fits behind the bumper here, where the bumper grooves out to hold it in place. It sits really nice. I like how it sits. It looks to me like it's got a little bit of rake because of the tires. The front end is dropped nice and low. The rear end, the rear tires just kind of right on the edge of the fenders, just right on the edge, which looks pretty tough in a street truck. And then we got those monster exhausts. Now, I would have ran my exhaust all the way out the back or stacks on it. That's how I would have done it. As you'll notice on mine, I did not put the chrome side steps on. There's a little groove here in the front of those rear fenders, and I like that. And when I put those side steps on, I just didn't, it looked too busy. It looked too farm trucky for me, like a utility step. So I didn't put those on. Well, I had them in place. I was gonna glue them, and I decided not to. It's a custom street truck, and that's your option. So I left it off. What I would do underneath the hood different next time, aside from trying to find a big block, is that on the fan, the bump out on the front of the fan seems to be what keeps that nice aluminum looking radiator from fitting in the hood, and that would really add to the look of the truck. So I would take my clippers and snip off what looks to be the fan clutch on the front of that, and then it would fit and nobody would really notice because they would be right up against each other. And I think you'd be able to get that cool looking radiator on there as if they put in a double thick or aftermarket radiator cooling system on there. Once the truck's all together, I think my idea to do the billet aluminum trim, which was so big in those days with those billet aluminum wheels, was a good idea. I like the look of it. I like the way it stands out so it's not all blue and tinted, along with that wood bed with the Sharpie marker, which simulates more billet aluminum, and the taillights done up like that, plus the way that I did the chassis, where I did it in that gray instead of a black, I think that all came out to be a really sweet look. The decals, of course, there's minimal ones, marker lights, Scottsdale emblems, and the side logos came out beautifully without a problem. So, highly recommend the kit. I will link in the description. From what I hear, Model Roundup should be getting these in pretty soon. I want to thank Revell USA for sending this over, and I want to thank all you for watching the video. When you get your 77 Street Truck, build it for you, have fun, and always remember, this is a hobby.